Welcome back to another episode of Alabama Bass Guide. I have a guide trip today, and it's probably the windiest day I've ever had a guide trip on Guntersville. We had sustained 50 mile an hour winds when this front came through, a lot of power outages. It was insane. And of course, let's go fishing, right? So we got out here and it was a pretty special day. Stay tuned, you're gonna wanna watch this. Hit that subscribe button. So stay tuned, you're gonna wanna watch this video. I might catch a really big one. Shh.
How's it going?
Yeah, bud, how are you?
A little too windy for the kayak.
Yeah, for most part.
Windy for most boats.
Yeah, out there, I don't wanna be.
Yeah, you'd be all right in here. First cast?
First cast.
Oh my gosh. That's awesome. Grab him. Good karma. Love it.
Good guy.
Yeah, I guess. You want your, maybe be the last. You never know. Let's take a picture. Don't let him go. We just got to make sure we get a picture of a bass today. I didn't have time to start my camera and he's like reeling in a bass. It's hilarious. That kayak fisherman up there was watching and I gave him a thumbs up.
There you go.
The hot flashes. It's so warm still.
I know, I'm like, I have no idea how to dress right now. Put some more layers on. Is it gonna be cool? Is it gonna be hot?
And I need a new roof, so it'll be like two birds, one stone.
Right.
Yeah. That is the quickest no skunk ever.
Right.
It's awesome. Push away from the dock, boom, bass. Another one? What do you got, a crappie? Is this a crappie? Oh my, I've never seen a crappie in my life eat a chatterbait. In my life. What is going on? That's insane. Never in my life of guiding. That's saying something. I've done this for 12 years.
Beautiful fish.
I ain't that big of a crappie down here, but dude, but I'm just like, that's
no, give me a picture.
No, what's more rare is the fact I don't think you guys can't appreciate it because how rare that is.
That's a big crappie for us.
Oh, it's about average down here, or maybe a little less. What happens is like right after it rains, these fish will use these mud lines. See how it's like, and they'll actually use it as an ambush point.
Oh.
So they'll sit in it and come out of it and think they're sneaky. They're kind of like cats. You know, a cat will hide under a chair in the living room, but you can see it, but he thinks he's sneaky.
Right. Yeah.
That's what a bass is. Tim's got the hot stick. What, that rod? Anything's for sale at the right price.
Right?
Oh, crazy. Maybe some do. There's one. Pretty good one. Oh, he come off! About a 5-pounder.
Oh, nice. That was a beast.
Got him? Yeah. Gosh, just keep reeling. You got him?
There
he
go.
Where's he at? Oh, he's bought one hook in him left.
Oh.
Good job.
Oh.
You want to grab him?
Yeah, I'll try not to stick him still. Oh.
You're good.
Get back to
him. There you go.
All right.
You're going to make him famous. Hold him up with the sun in his face.
So pretty.
Yeah. That's a fat one. They like a chatterbait there too, black and blue. God mercy! Another big one. But they're just like, they're not really wanting it. He pushed it at me. I hooked him for a split second. Jerk. Come back. Little one. He's not that big. Isn't that crazy? You can go back and get him.
There he goes.
When I didn't have a hook in his face, he was always a big one.
That I did notice from listening to a lot of.
I'll bet it's the positivity though. You always got to believe it's a big one, right? It's not even that, because it's like it lives on in perpetuity on YouTube.
Right, forever.
Forever. Got another one. Another big one. This is a giant. We get the net. This is a giant.
Looks like you're on one.
I don't know. Maybe right? Right? Oh my god. Wow. Right. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Yes! Oh my god! Are you videoing?
Yes.
Look, he's got us an 8-pounder probably.
Oh
my god! We lost a 5-pounder there earlier! What if it's the same one? What if it was bigger? He was never coming up. Let's go! It's gonna be on TikTok. Oh, I gotta put him in line. What a great time! Give me a good net, man! Oh, let's put him in.
There for a second, I'm like, this is either gonna go good or it's gonna go bad.
Guys, throw in there. There's gotta be a bunch more in there. All right, ready? She's ready.
All right.
You wanna put her on the scale? Or hold her mouth, I'll clamp it. I bet she's close to 7. All right, you ready? Oh, 7.5. 7.3, settled on 7.3. 7.2, we're calling it 7.3. I'm gonna let her go. Thanks for playing, big baby. She cool. Yeah. After having the heated seats, I won't go back. It's just, I'm not here when it's so cold all the time. Guntersville's an exceptional lake. There's literally fish everywhere here. You know, fish are in probably 2% of the water once you get out of the grass. So that's the grass just really concentrates them. But when you find that 2% spot with your electronic, like in the summer, there's 100 bass. Clark's Hill, they were just at Clark's Hill for the Invitationals, which it was the FLW Tour. And guy had one of the biggest bags final day. Two of the biggest bags, 22 and 23 pounds, came from a half a foot of water in mud on a buzzbait.
I got a bad bite,
though. Oh, yeah, I get it. Oh my god, he ate it on the surface. I was burning it in. Did you see that? How cool was that? Oh, what a cool day. I told you, some days you can't do no wrong. It's weird. See you, buddy.
Just a little one.
Little one, he's fun.
We don't want to tell anybody about that, do we?
Lake Motel.
Yeah, right. Nice one. It's fun anyways.
Gunner.
Yeah. They just keep catching them. I can't stop them from catching them.
Crappie?
Yeah.
Nice bass. She's on them. Reel them in. She's got 3. That's a better one, I think. That one might be good. You are on fire, girl. Oh, that's a good one. Got him.
All right.
Look at there.
We're
ruining someone's tournament tomorrow.
Yeah, we are.
He's off of it. Here, you grab this.
All right.
We'll get your picture for that one. I was telling you, they bit this bait. Now you got a baker's dozen. All right, we'll trade you.
Okay.
Nice fish. Hold her up.
All right.
Heck yeah. Where's your camera? Right behind me? Right here?
I think so.
Or yeah. Is that his?
So this was a special video because I don't think any of us wanted to come fish in 30 mile an hour winds, but we were like, hey, we're here. Make the best of it. These guys are from Minnesota. They did a great job. Everybody caught a bass today in these conditions. So I think that's a win, including a really big bass. So we got them again tomorrow. We're gonna take them fishing and hopefully they get some big bass tomorrow. We got really nice weather, a lot nicer than today. But the key bait was absolutely this red chatterbait. And that really big bass was even spitting up red crawdads in my live well. And look right here. We have crawdads in the live well that are red. And it just goes to show this time of year, they put on the feed bag and they want to eat these red crawfish, even in clear water. So if you're coming to Guntersville, stay strapped with a red chatterbait, put you some gaudy looking trailer on that thing. And my setup, I got a 6 2-to-1 Corrado DC. And this is a little special rod. My buddy gifted this to me. It's a 7.6 medium heavy Conquest. It's one of my only Conquests I have. It's a bad dude. So I'm not gonna tell you to go buy this because it's like $600-$700 rod, but I love this rod. It's my baby. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like, subscribe as always. Love you guys. See you next time. Bye.